James Maddison, you must have a real mixture of emotions after that. Your first hat-trick of your career, and yet you finished on the losing side.
Yeah, you could say I don't really have a mixture of emotions, if I'm honest. I have one emotion, which is disappointment. To score three goals in the first half away from home and not come away with at least a point is it's hard to take, yeah.
Yeah, and the way you started the game, Hull were on top, but you wrestled that back and you got yourselves 3-1 up. So the way you've defended this season, you must have fancied going on from there to wrap the points up.
Yeah, I think that's been one of our positives this season, being able to shut teams out, especially away from home. We've had a lot of clean sheets, but we didn't manage to do that today, and that's why we're going home empty-handed.
Yeah, Daniel Farker has talked about it being more to do with the way Norwich defended than the way Hull attacked. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, to an extent, yeah. We didn't defend well enough. We didn't defend runners into the box from deep. We didn't really track. We didn't read it as well as we have done in the past, and that's why we've conceded four goals normally.
Yeah. You're Norwich's top scorer. We've talked before about the responsibility you're taking with penalties and to be the main man with the goals, but it looks as if you thrive with that responsibility.
Yeah, as I've said, pressure and responsibility is something that only drives me on, you know. Just little things like being the penalty taker and stuff and having that, you could say pressure. I don't feel it as pressure, but people would say pressure on my shoulders to score from the spot, especially after already scoring, you know. I thrive off that, and I'm happy to get three goals, yeah.
Yeah, and that's the thing, isn't it? I know you've got a bit of a sore throat. Daniel Farker said you've been struggling this week, but it shows how much you want to play, that you're out there putting in another shift for the team.
Yeah, after a result like that, I question why I want to do it. But, I love football, you know. I haven't been well the last couple of days. As the boss said, I had a room to myself, had breakfast on my own and stuff, stayed away from the boys, didn't want to get anyone else ill. But, yeah, as I said, just overriding with disappointment.
Yeah, and just to finish with, the team's drawn a lot of games recently, and trouble with that, it means we're suddenly looking at a long run or a few weeks without a win, doesn't it? And does that change the mood with the squad and the mood with the fans? Did you worry about that?
I don't think we worry about that, because prior to this game we'd lost 1 in 14, so you can take positives from that instead of looking at the fact that we hadn't won in 5. But we've got a team of individuals who are capable of winning games, and today I think, especially after being 3-1 up, we have to look at ourselves as a group of individuals and look back on why we didn't come away with anything from the game.
Well, today, James, thank you.
Thank you. Yes, thank you.